I want to switch back to the topic of the traditional marketing with a new eye. First of all, I want to give you the motivation for this. Hospitals are seen as the central institution of healthcare, the center of medical progress, and last but not least, an important factor in today's economy. The reproductive medicine and its neighbor specialist fields are young fields of activity where fast progress is going on. This means a huge challenge for clinics, doctors, and the society. A high standard of performance is to be guaranteed, but high quality leads to high costs involved for guaranteeing the level of performance. Due to numerous changes in the healthcare system and the political environment, hospitals are facing a growing competitive pressure. So a need for orientation to market economy arises, aiming the improvements of cost effectiveness of the service provision or of the service provider. This is why there is a need for professional promotion of good services, which enables the IVF clinic entering in a good market position, facing competition with others. This strategy has to guarantee and ensure the future of long-term success. During this Congress, we already learned about some of those possibilities. In my session, I would like to present you a further possibility, which maybe is not yet known a lot, geomarketing. Is anybody of you using already geomarketing? Nobody? Do you have an idea about geomarketing, what it is? How many of you have an idea? One, two, three, four? Okay. So maybe we can explore a new subject. What first comes to our minds when reading the term geomarketing is the composition of the two single words, geo, for geography, and marketing. First, I would like to clarify what the term geomarketing stands for. In English-speaking countries, often the term business GIS is used. Both terms can be compared, but nevertheless, there exist slight differences. It goes without saying that it is based in the marketing department. Just as in the consumer market, also the clinical marketing counts four different tools, which are the following. The service, the offered service in the healthcare sector, the consideration, mostly common, we do not use the term price here. As in most cases, the price has been fixed beforehand, and it's more about the utilization of a clinical service. We differ between the so-called core service and optional services. Next is the access. Access to the performance, which means the physical accessibility of the clinic and communication regarding the offered services. And last but not least, promotion. This tool serves for presenting the three before named areas to the public, which is in our understanding the patient or the referrer. The combination of these four tools is called the marketing mix. Geomarketing is a special point of view that presumes that the market is spatial, and therefore company key figures can differ depending to the region. This is how common marketing is supplemented by the spatial point of view. Doing so, a huge range of new fields of application is created. We do not just ask who is our patient, but in the future maybe we will ask where is my patient from, or where do my patients come from, or better said, on which channels or route the patient is brought to my clinic. As a conclusion, we can summarize the following. Geomarketing is the term for planning, coordinating, and controlling patient or clinic-based activities using geographic information systems. Methods are used that create a spatial reference of the stored data, analyze it, and are able to present them visually. The sources of geomarketing can be found much before computers and software programs conquered the world. In former time, it especially used to be a special discipline of the big industry and big-sized companies or some specific groups. Back then, they used paper-made maps and colored pins and pieces of strings. And on those maps, they defined areas like the catchment area of companies, shops, or the visualization of marketing activities. This has been the most successful possibility for learning which are the remaining gaps on the maps that have to be addressed. Nevertheless, soon the possibilities of that method were limited. As you can imagine, there is a lot of effort needed for creating such a map, including the above-mentioned data. Additionally, there are a few possibilities for a flexible presentation of external data, which then had to be used using additional lists for analysis. There are a lot of application fields for geomarketing. And right now, I just would like to name some of those in representation of all other respective fields of this application. Let's start naming the patient relationship management. Where are most of my patients from? It is logical that the patient that shoulders a long way to see the doctor is most likely to highly appreciate the doctor's work. Thanks to geomarketing analysis, we can show in a very detailed way where our patients are from and having our conclusion from this data. A second field of application are organizational analysis, like, for example, for the location planning or the expansion planning. Maybe someone would like to open a second practice or branch. So the question that arises is the following: where is the best location to open a second practice or branch? When talking about application fields of geomarketing in the field of IVF, we may not forget to talk about the referral marketing. Where are my referrers and which patients do they send to see me or where not? Are there possible geographic gaps on the map that I could cover in the future? As a last example for the numerous fields of application of geomarketing, I would like to name the patient acquisition. Here, a target group analysis is highly recommended. Question is, in which area local promotion is worthwhile? The target group of all activities is the group of customers. In an IVF clinic, there are three different groups of stakeholders being included when talking about customers. It's the patient, as the one receiving the performance. It's the health insurance or some governmental funds, as the ones covering a part or all of the costs involved. And the referrer, who highly influences the patient's buying decision. Hardly any IVF clinic regularly analyzes why regional doctors do not or not longer refer patients to their clinic. Consulting managers often notice that those clinics do not even realize if a referrer stops referring patients. They hardly know anything about the structure of the referrers. Most clinics rely on the personal relation between the referring and the attending physician. Please don't get me wrong. Of course, this is also very important. But once we are talking about marketing and market competition, it is not quite recommendable just sticking to personal relationship as a marketing tool. In today's practical presentation of geomarketing, I will just stick to data of patients and referrers and focus on these two areas. Let us switch to the practical part of this session. As we will just realize a short journey to the field of geomarketing today, I will try not to go too much in detail. My aim for today's presentation is giving you a general idea and understanding of how geomarketing basically works and which are the most essential requirements for it. Let's start talking about the basic structure of geomarketing. The basis for each and every successful analysis is very well structured data. So data from our target groups, like the patients or the referrers, have to be collected. Almost every IVF clinic is already using certain software for documentation and collection of relevant therapy data. Should this requirement not be covered till now, it has to be implemented. We do not just talk about quantitative key figures, but also about qualitative ones. While interacting with our customers, the addresses, or not customers, our patients, the addresses have to be checked and eventually adjusted on an ongoing basis. Therefore, strict discipline is required, as well as from the management, as from the staff. For the next step, we need the so-called geo-coordinates. The process you can see on the slide is called geocoding. The term geocoding stands for the issuing and assigning of geographical coordinates to an address. Afterwards, the coordinates will be stored in the database next to the address. I have prepared a little example for you. Let's just use the hotel address for realizing this example. This address is similar to those addresses stored in our IVF database. Most commonly, it consists of street, house number, zip code, city, and so on. If this analysis is to be realized less personalized and the catchment area is not too big, we also can use the postcode in combination with the city, so without street and house number. We hand the data over to a so-called geocoder. A geocoder is just a special software or web service that realizes the confirmation of the address. As a result, we receive the geocoordinates in the parameters latitude and longitude. As you might imagine, there are numerous providers of the most diverse geocoding modules out there. There are a couple of free providers and also commercial solutions. Before effectively using it, a couple of aspects have to be taken into consideration, such as data protection, licensing, usability, and so on. If you like to, please feel free to retry this example, as I have used the free Google Maps geocoder. Just insert the address in your internet browser. The first part of what you should insert always remains the same, but just the orange marked text is to be changed using the new address. Promptly, Google Maps API delivers a text file which might for some look quite strange or confusing. But if you have a closer look at the structure, you will see the entry for the location and the consecutive values latitude and longitude. By the way, the reverse way to the transformation of geocoordinates into an address is called reverse geocoding. We also can verify this using the same example and indicating both of the beforehand stated values directly in the Google Maps search. Once again, promptly we receive an answer. At this time, it is a map, the marked address, including information like street, house number, postcode, zip code, and new, of course, we also received the street view photos. Let's get back to the idea of the basic structure. After having completed all data with geographic data, we can now start analyzing and visualizing. Therefore, two steps have to be done. First, we have to work on reasonable questions or complex queries that is geographically analyzed. A simple example is the question, where are my customers from, or the patients? For that, we would realize a query on our patient master data, and as a result, we will obtain a list of all addresses that not necessarily needed to have a link to the personalized data. And second, we need for the visualizing on a map, a GIS, a geographic information system, and for that, we hand over the data to that system and let it prepare it visually. Just as is the case for geocoding modules, there also exist different free and commercial software and web services. Now, I would like to show you some praxis examples, and maybe you will find some impulses for someone attending this session. And as the basic software, I use the marketing tool out of the Meditex portfolio, because I have all address data. First of all, I would like to show you how simple the usage of a geocoder is, because with this screenshot, you see it from the Meditex Mama, it's the marketing manager program. In the database on the left side, I have my data structure. I choose just the IVF clinics in Germany as a basis. In the second step, I choose what kind of attributes. It means I want to have street, address, house number, zip code. And afterwards, I just start the geocoder and hand over the data. And as a result, I receive this list. And in this list, I have these two columns with the latitude and longitude. This is just for the background information. By the way, you don't need to repeat this step every time. In the best of the cases, if you create a new address, a new patient, or you change something, the geocoder is doing this job automatically in the background. So this is just for you to see how it works. Let's get some analysis done. So we have the possibility now to represent this on a geographic map. You might ask how you can get this data for analysis, but it is very simple because in most countries or in the internet, you already can find lists of all IVF clinics and there are directories. You just have to feed your database, and out of this, you are able to create the geo-coordinates with such a tool. In my example here, I just want to ask, where are my competitors? This is the view on a country-based level. In the most ideal case, I also will have the possibility of adjusting different zoom levels in order to realize analysis, and for example, of a special federal state like it is here, Bavaria. On this map, we can see our own clinic, namely the red one in the center, and all neighbored clinics, which are the blue ones. So these are my competitors. So now we come to the first target group, the referrers. Here you can see an example for the visualization of all my referrers in the broader surroundings of my clinic. You can see the clinic as the red symbol, like it was before. Also, we do not yet analyze a lot of different data. We receive a first impression of the catchment area of our clinic. Let's now get a step further in analyzing this data. For doing so, we zoom a bit closer to IVF practice. Now we would like to know how exactly our network of referrers work. Therefore, we need data regarding our patients. Now we can see both data integrated in this single map, our referrers and our patients. Thanks to geocoding, I can bring any mass of data in a relation to another and let it be presented visually by the system. Following that analysis, it is easily can see my catching main areas. You can see this in the green circles. But you can also notice in which areas around my clinics there still exists unused potential, or where maybe relations to the referrers are not quite well yet, the red one. One practical tip, by the way, it would be worth storing the information before and after having realized special marketing activities, for also having a visual result whether those activities has been worth it. Of course, you can also get the visualization of how far your patients are traveling to you. In this example, it's another zoom level on the European level. Just to give you also an impression, it's not only about addresses and patients, I can also bring my treatments in a relation, and it's a funny. And there are several ways you can get a geographic information system. Some of them are free, some of them are commercial. So it's your decision. And I want to say thank you for your attention.